We would have liked to continue on with this conversation longer and longer, that the viewers enjoy you more and more, but we don't like to burden you, hoping to meet you on another opportunity, inshallah, in United Arab Emirates in near future.
I'm very happy also to be with you, and I'm very, very grateful to the people of the UAE and to His Highness Sheikh Zayed bin Al Nahyan, because he made it possible for me now to come and go in as a national of Abu Dhabi, You see, previously, it took me about 3 years, you know, to make my turn to come here. But in the past 3 weeks, I have come to this country 3 times, gone out and come in, gone out and come in, because I have got a multiple visa, thanks to His Highness Sheikh Zayed and to his departments. And to the Abu Dhabi TV, because they did something for me which put me on the map of the Muslim world. They dubbed my tape into Arabic.
The change of heart, look at the Muslims. Look at them. Jesus said, by the fruits you shall know them. Do men gather figs from the thistle or grapes from the thorn? He said, every good tree will be a good fruit and every evil tree will be evil fruit. Here is the test. The fruits. Islam has created the biggest society of teetotalers in the world. There are some 1,000 million Muslims in the world, and almost as a whole, they are teetotalers. They don't imbibe alcohol. Here is the fruits. My own particular race, the most racist people on earth, you know, the Hindus of India, the caste Hindus, you know, the supermost Brahmin caste, my nation. And you see, the same nation, the most racist nation on earth, becomes one who accepts the black and the white, the rich and the poor in his brotherhood. A change. With all these claims that are being made for Christianity, Jesus Christ transforming people's lives, you know, the old you goes out of you and the new you comes into you. I says, my dear brothers and sisters, look, in this mighty nation of America, according to Brother Swaggart, 11 million drunkards. That's what he says. 11 million drunkards and 44 million heavy drinkers, your nation. And Brother Swaggart says, I see no difference between them, means 55 million. He considers them to be drunkards. The only difference is that he's not going far enough. In Islam, we say even you're a social drinker. The Holy Quran says, but before that, the Prophet Muhammad said, so whatever intoxicates in greater quantity is forbidden even in smaller quantity. No excuse for a nip or a tot. Out. The Holy Quran says, Ya ayyuha allazina amanu. So, O you who believe, innama al-khamru, most certainly intoxicants, wal maisiru and gambling. Brother Swaggart in his book on gambling says, 54 billion a year you are squandering on gambling. Wal maisiru, wal ansabu and fortune telling, wal azlamu and idol worship, rijzum min amali shaitan, are an abomination of Satan's handiwork, fajtanibuhu la'allakum tuflihun. It's a shun such abomination that you may prosper. And wine barrels were emptied in the streets of Medina, never to be refilled. This is the fruit. This is the fruit of this teaching. With 2,000 years of preaching, look at it. You have these powers of miracle working. Christ gives life, he heals the sick. Muhammad couldn't. In the name of Muhammad, they couldn't do it. I says, my brothers, you don't read the scriptures. Jesus Christ, he said, for there shall arise many false Christs and false prophets who will show you great signs and wonders if it were possible to deceive the very elect. If false Christ can do that, if false Christ can perform miracles, if false prophets can perform miracles, then I says, is this a test of your faith? No. Then Jesus Christ tells those who are doing this miraculous work, he's telling you in the Gospel of St. Matthew, that on that day, on the last day, on the day of judgment, he says, many will come to me on that day, saying, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in thy name, and in thy name cast out devils, and in thy name do many mighty works? In your name, in the name of Jesus. Didn't you do all these things? Didn't we do all that? He said, yes. He said, then I will profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. I said, yeah, explain. You. He won't tell the Jews, depart from me. For sake, get away. I don't know you. He won't tell the Hindus, get away from me. Or the atheists, get away from me. He will tell you. I want to know why. Why would he tell you? I don't even know you. Get out. I says, look, these are not the test. John the Baptist, according to Jesus, one of the mightiest messengers of God, Jesus says, among those born of women, there has not risen another greater than John the Baptist. And yet he performed no miracles. Did he? Show me. What did he do? What miracles? No, miracle is not a test. But the greater miracle is that without any miracles, you transform nations. Nations are transformed. 1,000 million people, they don't imbibe alcohol because of the dictates of Muhammad.
Without that, I would not have been known in the Arab world. Today, every Egyptian child seems to know me. Every Muslim he meets me from the Arab countries, they stop me in the street. And for this, I have to thank the UAE government, Abu Dhabi TV, and His Highness Sheikh Zayed, because he received me with such kindness and hospitality. I can't express it. You know, the humility with which he received me. As I was trying to apologize for exploiting his time, he says, no, man, he feels honored to receive me. He makes me sit on his right-hand side. And 1 hour he kept me there trying to tap my brains, and I was also trying to tap his brains. And there's so much I learned from him that can help me in my work intellectually. Ideas he has given me, which I'm going to implement. I started implementing already, alhamdulillah. And he's asked me to do certain special jobs, which I'm prepared to carry out. So I am a servant of the Muslims wherever they want me, and Abu Dhabi, I think, will be my second home, because I have a multiple visa. Anytime I want to feel like coming in, I can come in, and anytime I can go out and come back again. So I'm very, very grateful to Allah Bari Ta'ala, and for the Sheikh, and to the people of the UAE for making my life easy for me.
Welcome anytime in Emirates. We thank you for this interview, and we thank you for this chance that you have made available to us and to our viewers to enjoy your ideas and thoughts. May Allah grant you longer life, and may the peace of Allah, His mercy and His blessings be upon you.